Patsy is back, and she is here with us. Welcome inside Level 2 Team 96. Gotta say special good morning going out to Miss Patrice Roberts.
Good morning.
How are you doing, girl?
I'm fine. I feel
that's
sexy. It was kind of hard to get up from bed this early, though.
Miss, especially
had a lot
when
of traffic.
And the traffic. And
late. Sorry for being late.
That's all right. That's all right. but at least
I
you're
know
here.
Mine.
Yeah, Clyde.
I like to say again, wow.
Thank you.
So, Patsy, what's been going on? How has the season been treating you, especially
this
since after
Carnival?
Season
have been wonderful. You know, a lot of great things have been happening for me as a person.
Right.
I'm now under new management. You know, so my team have been working from Carnival to now. I've been touring, getting things together, rebranding.
Right. You know, actually
getting ready to prepare for bumper season 2016.
Right.
Like, I am feeling so happy and comfortable in my space and where I'm at. And in no doubt, 2016 gonna be a successful one.
Exactly. And you know, we always talking about image, because especially for the female, you have to have your game plan on,
of
as
course.
Carnival done. What direction are you think you're looking at going
into? I don't even know, you know. I don't even know.
It's
because for me, I'm always transforming, always trying to be different, but it's gonna definitely blow people's minds away.
As usual.
But for me, it's just to be different. You know, so I wanna kinda come across as if I'm almost new again,
right,
to the masses, to the audience, to my fans. But I don't know what that new is. But
I'm
working on it.
I'm glad you brought that up, because I wanted to talk about your growth from inception to now. And I get certain messages from people and stuff, Facebook, Instagram, and somebody asked me to ask you, what do you think has been the biggest change or growth that you've had from since you started to now, and in terms of your voice, in terms of your image, what is that
the biggest
been?
Change for me? Well, I would say, especially this year, was to actually branch off from the ecstatic HD family,
right,
and going on my own. It comes like it felt like a baby leaving their parents' home. You know, you had to start all over again. It was hard at first, you know, because they are all I knew.
Yeah.
They were all I knew. And, you know, leaving, I didn't know what I was going to get myself into. But for me, I am always excited about new challenges. I'm always excited about change. And the sky was the limit for me. I just picked myself up, had my hard times. I cried, I must be honest.
Of
you know,
course,
I cried.
Of course.
I felt emotional.
Right, yeah.
But I'm here, I'm standing, I'm making my own decision. I'm the captain of my own ship. You know, it's all about, I mean, growth comes with hard experience. It comes with tears, it comes with pain, sorrow, you know. So here I am, growth.
Well, speaking of growth, you know, a lot of people too have been deciding, listen, it seems like we should be moving in the direction where we should be backed by a band. You think Patrice Roberts, the band, is going to be coming soon? Or
it probably might be coming soon. I don't want to put that out there for people to be like, oh, I'm expecting a band.
Okay.
But for me, I want to swim in the ocean by myself for a little bit, kind of find myself as an artist, because I'm now solo. You know, find myself, find my space, give fans more of me, and then make my decision by next 2 years. But
right,
for now, it's just about me and my fans, and giving the fans a lot more of me and my music and my repertoire and my voice and my vibes. I have so much to give, and you're gonna see that 2016.
Right. And talking about the track that was just played a little while ago, give us some background information on that.
This song was written by Problem Child. You know, Problem Child is my main writer, Colonel Roberts as well, but Problem Child and I have been working hand in hand as an artist, as a person. I mean, we have that chemistry like no other, as a writer and an artist. You know, he will write something and send it, and that's it. I don't need,
you don't even have to look at it.
Exactly.
You know,
he
right.
knows my voice.
Trust
he
me.
Knows my range. He knows what I feel. And from the moment I've heard that song, I was like, yeah, people could relate to this, because for now, I know everybody, some people take loans for the season, some people already have their money prepared and ready to spend all the money. Because I mean, it's not just about spending your money, it's about investing in self. You know, and investing in who you are, because sometimes you work so hard, and at that moment you need to give yourself a treat. If you have $1 million and you think you just need to go to Spain and spend it out, for me, I am going to, because there's one life to live. That's the kind of gist of the song.
Well, I mean, that's a typical thinking of most Trinidadians. Eh?
Yeah.
Let's just have a good time.
Exactly.
And study
live
it
for
after.
Today.
Yeah.
Live for today.
Yeah.
And
everything,
after,
even
yeah.
disaster, and make it fun. That's why I love my country, you know.
Yeah.
So let's talk about management. I know you're telling us that you changed management a little while ago, and how important management and the backing of the team is to you.
Well, my managers are from Toronto, Soka Bookings and Ivan Berry. They are really important because as an artist, we have to really focus. I mean, we are creative minds. You have to focus on music. You have to focus on image. You have so much things to focus on. You have your personal issues. Mm-hmm. You have everything. The management, for me, is to just iron out everything else, to deal with people who come in, who want to book you behind the back, for writers, for everything. I mean, but so far...
Is that stressful to have to deal with and wonder, Lord, can I trust this person with my money, with my life,
in terms of
my bread
management
and butter? Yeah, management.
Of course. You know, I've been through a lot of experiences, bad experiences that I wouldn't share. But, you know, from that bad experience, I've learned a lot. So I'm always on top of my game. I will call them 24/7. I don't care if you sign contract. I will call and be like, hey, let me see this. So far, it's been good. You know, everything is on the table. Everything has been open. And we have an open relationship. And so far, so good. The sky's the limit. And I just put everything else in God's hand.
So with you experiencing some of these horrible experiences, what would be some of your advice that you can give new and upcoming artists who are looking for management? Because I think some people take it so easily. Hey, I find you in the industry. You can be my manager. Yeah. They don't do their research.
Exactly. So, like you said, you could first of all do your research. Secondly, don't put your trust in everybody. Mm. Don't put your trust and faith and hope, especially when it comes to money. You know, money changes everything. Changes the aspect.
Yep.
In the beginning, when the money's not there, we will smile. But when money starts coming in, things will change. Just be on top of your game. Ask questions.
Yes.
You know, don't leave it up to them. You know, you could even call promoters. Call, do things like that. You know, for me, this is my business. I'm not playing.
Yeah, exactly. You have to. You have to be involved. And Patrice, of course, for the men out there, you know, they always look forward to the body and want to know what's coming. I had to ask, listen, like, Clyde, there, you grinning. Our camera guy, he done grinning already.
No, Patrice looks good.
I mean, come on,
And I know for a fact Patrice puts in the work.
No, lesbo vibes, but
no, thank you. I take my gym work really serious. If I'm home for a week away from tour, I go to gym a week. You know, I believe in taking care of your body. Mm-hmm. Not just for people, for men to look at, but for me, for my personal self-confidence. Mm-hmm. You know, I take care of myself. I try to eat good. Sometimes I cheat a little bit, but I tend to eat properly and I tend to take care of my body.
Give us a rundown in a day from morning to night when you wake up. What's your day like?
From morning, I'm not really a morning person, so I will call my trainer and be like, hey, Pablo, I'm not coming out early,
right,
so... 3 o'clock. So from 3 o'clock, we go to gym. We work for an hour. I take my protein and I eat protein again. I drink as much protein as I can. And studio back home. It's just
what about personal time?
I kind of, for me, personal time is not really important. For me right now.
Okay.
You know, it's important at times, but for me, my job, I take this serious. As long as this is intact, then personal life could come anytime.
Because they're not going to come with the relationship question.
Here comes the back now.
We wanted to find out. Because, I mean, come on, you're young, you're out there. You know, would you even have time? I know you're saying that now your focus is on your music and stuff like that. Is it because of personal past experiences or right now? What is your reasoning behind that? Because a lot of guys will say, well, I'm to Patrice boy, Waka. What's going on?
Because I've been constantly touring. Who has time for...
Well,
they
probably have somebody in the industry like yourself.
Oh, no.
See what I told you? See what I told you?
You ain't going there again? All right, Miss Patsy. Well, anyway, let's talk about future projects in terms of your music.
In terms of my music, I plan to release every single month. End of the month.
Oh, really?
So okay. Look for something at the end of the month. November, end of the month. And I'm going like that till Carnival. I'm doing that because, for me, I just want to give fans the opportunity to see a different side of me.
Right.
You're not just going to hear the wine and jam. You're going to hear she's singing, using her voice and giving my life story and some of the music. And for me, I also want to, or planning to, not just come on stage and grab a mic with the DJ. I want to put on a show.
A show performance
for my fans. So I have a lot in store, doing a lot of video. And then after the Carnival, I'm also... tapping into dancehall and reggae and big collaborations. So you're going to hear a lot more to come.
Very good, very good. We can't wait for that as well. Yeah.
Well, tell us about the new single, Nobody.
Nobody was written by a young guy from St. Vincent. His name is Joel, and produced by Mark Cyrus. Basically, he wrote the song and he sent it to me. Mm-hmm. But hearing the song is basically everything that I've gone through and everything that I want to transcend to the fans. Nobody is taking time for yourself and not feeling like you need anybody company, you know, to feel special or to feel like, you know, like you need company to live or to move on, you know. So for me, nobody, I'm playing mass this year. I don't need nobody to be on the road with me. Right. Any man could whine, but I'm coming by myself to have a good time, basically. Just of the song.
Fantastic. And just before we head into that, tell us what you feel about your fellow artists' music so far coming out for the season.
I'm loving what I'm hearing. I'm excited. To all the artists like myself, I want to say, you know, good luck for the season 2016. Let's create great music. Let's live in peace, love, and unity. Let's do this and have, and let's, you know, put soca music on the map. Mm-hmm. You know, so far I'm loving what I'm hearing. Destra Show Off, Nadia Batson, Sorry, Fayan, these kind of crossover African music. I love it.
Yeah. And competition-wise, jumping back in again?
Competition-wise, it depends on the song. Mm-hmm. For me, it depends on the song. If I have a huge song for the season, hell yeah, I'm then going in.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. If not...
How important is the competition to you?
I think the competition is really important, not just to me, but to all artists. It gives you an opportunity to be seen on a different light on that night, you know, because everybody's locked on internationally.
Yeah, internationally as well, yeah.
So, yeah, they get to see everybody on a different level.
With biggest props. Marketing pool.
Exactly. Exactly. So, I don't want to be out, but it depends on the song.
Okay,
and
great.
It always helps to be in a competition.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. All right, well, Patrice... This is your floor.
So the name of this new track is called Nobody, written by Mark Cyrus. Sorry, produced by Mark Cyrus, written by Joel. Let's go.
Yeah, with Nobody. And Patrice, I always had to say that out of many of the female artists, you are one of them who truly can sing.
Thank you.
The vocals always on point.
Thank you very
it's
much.
It's not a by the way, let me try a thing. Nah,
thank
always,
you.
Always, always.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Yeah, I agree.
Of course, I mean, that's what we had to say.
Yeah. Yeah,
so, Patrice, talk about, you know, your social media presence and
for all the fans who want to follow me, is on Instagram. It's Patrice Roberts 1 and Facebook and Twitter, Patrice R Music. So follow me.
Are you active on social media?
Always. I'm active on IG.
Right. Yeah.
Facebook is being handled by the team.
Yeah.
But Instagram, all me. I try my very best to respond to the fans as much as possible.
Sometimes
I can't.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes you respond, you will, you know, comment, and I don't comment or feel like I'm not listening.
Yeah,
but I will try to speak to my fans as much as I can.
All right. And seeing that you are now on with different management team now, bookings, how can they reach you?
Bookings is bookpatricerobots@gmail.com. Yes.
All right. Well, Patrice, I want to wish you all the best.
Thank you.
I ain't had to say anything else, you know, Patrice. I mean, I think you're a veteran, as young as you are.
Thank you.
You've been in the business for a very, very long time. You know what you're doing. I can see the transformation, your aura, everything, where you're leading to. And,
The sky's the limit, and I'm happy. And thank you to 96.1 for always supporting me. Raw always calling me, hey, you need to come and interview. So thank you to Raw, and thank you to 96.1.
No problem.
And all the radio DJs and everybody for supporting. Thank you.
It's always a pleasure seeing you.
Always,
from
always.
I
find you smiling plenty, you know.
I always smile.
Look how close Kai is to her.
Why? Why not?
All right, Patrice, thanks so much for passing through.
Thank you very much.
You're not a stranger.
Of course.
Anytime you're ready.
Pass next end of the month.
Yes. That's true.
Yes.
All right, guys.